are ready. We're going to document the solar eclipse, right? But are you worried maybe you're ruining your phone or cameras? We've been talking about this in the news. So we brought in today Sarah Lothian Hannah, the lead. It says lead, two leads. That means you're super important.
I guess I am.
In the teleprompter. She's the lead photographer over at NASA Glenn with some tips to kind of help you protect your devices. So this is very important. Welcome to the show.
Thank you for having me.
You are so important. So my first question is, how excited are you?
Oh, we are so
excited. How excited are you
to be? Once in a lifetime celestial event in here in Ohio.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
So there's a lot of different things. I know a lot of us probably won't be using these fancy things, which we'll talk about just in case you haven't, but they'll be using their cell phone. So
sure. So
we can ruin our cell phone, right?
We can. If you point any camera directly at the sun, you have a chance of damaging your sensor inside your camera.
Yeah.
So we want to make sure that we're protected on April 8th.
So filters are important.
They
and
are.
What do you have on the cell phone?
So if you can see here, there is a filter that kind of just snaps to the back of this. And it darkens significantly your the light coming in from the solar eclipse. So by having this filter on, we'll protect the sensor.
So you
on
have
your
to
smartphone.
Have that on. And you can look at it through your lens on the other side, right?
Yep.
That's okay.
Yes.
You have the, okay.
Yep,
it's just
long.
Like the glasses, so if you've tried the glasses on, I mean, you can't see a thing.
Right, you'll be able to see the sun and the eclipse
through it. And then snap, snap, snap away. Let's talk about some other filters that are very important. Show me, educate me on this, because that
sure.
looks very intimidating.
whether you have equipment that NASA has or not, every camera is going to need a solar filter.
Okay. And
this you can get from any reputable company. The American Astronomical Society has a website that you can check for a list of suppliers that are ISO certified.
Okay.
So you want to make sure that you have a good filter to
okay.
protect your expensive equipment.
And you talk about filters, like I was on Amazon. How do I trust Amazon's are legit?
Okay, yeah.
Okay, she's giving me the eye.
Yep, you want to make sure it's ISO certified.
ISO?
Yep.
ISO, yep. ISO, okay.
Yep. And if you look at the Astronomical Society website, they have a list where you can double check your purchase before you buy.
Okay, so that's good advice. But I think this is super important for those of you who are really excited about catching that. It's literally the totality is 3 minutes long is what they're
right.
saying.
Yeah.
So we need to practice, just like practicing for anything else.
Sure.
You don't have 3 minutes to stumble your way through, my friends. So
no.
Sarah, help us out.
Don't just expect to be a master on that day.
Right. I mean, we can shoot selfies like nobody's business, but this is serious.
Right. So it's really important to plan and prep ahead of time. Plan where you're going to be on the day of the eclipse.
Yeah.
Plan the equipment you're going to use. What lenses are you going to use? Are you going to use your cell phone? You might want to make sure you have your filters and everything.
Mm-hmm.
Another way to plan and practice ahead of time is to photograph the sun during a sunny day with your filter on. You want to practice with that filter because it darkens everything down.
That's a very good point. So,
yeah.
And with that said, with the sun, you can also practice with the moon too?
Sure.
Is that true?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay.
So during totality, it's going to be dark.
Okay.
So all your surroundings are going to change. It's sort of
do you remove and replace filters quickly, right?
Right.
Okay.
Right. So during totality, you actually can remove your filters. So you want to practice that ahead of time, too.
Oh, you can.
Make sure you can take that off quickly in the dark.
Okay. And I jotted down some other things from your website, frames per second. So if that's if you're doing, like, the quick shots?
Yeah, you want to practice your exposures. And
okay.
you want to take notes of what kind of exposures you need for your camera during while you're practicing photographing the sun and while you're practicing photographing the moon. So
okay.
the light changes so rapidly that you need
right.
to be prepared and you just don't have a lot of time to fumble around.
What is auto bracketing? I'm getting educated.
If you're
this
a photographer,
is class for all of us, take notes.
Yeah, if all you're right. a photographer, you should understand how to bracket your exposure. So some images are going to be light, some are going to be dark, and we won't go into the details.
Okay, but if you want a good one, you just easily snap. Okay, and then test shooting in twilight is
yeah.
a thing too? You can
yeah,
practice there?
Yeah, at nighttime, practice photographing the moon.
Yeah.
Practice focusing on the edge of the moon. Get your exposures right. And that'll just give you some practice just during the to mimic the total eclipse.
Okay, what do you have beside you?
Yeah,
this that looks very intense. Is that like a paparazzi camera?
It could be.
But it could very well
This is
well
how
could be.
We can zoom really close up on the moon with our 600 millimeter
really
lens.
Cool. So how have you been practicing? You're a professional. She does everything from like headshots to landscapes. Like, so like, what are you expecting? Like, what's some things you've been losing sleep over that you're excited about not losing?
Yeah,
sleep?
Yeah. It's just again practicing your settings, and this is a science experiment essentially.
Yeah, right.
And us at NASA, we're really good at those. So you want to make sure that you have your exposures written down ahead of time so you just don't have to do a lot of thinking. And you can take in the eclipse while you're there.
And again, if you want something for your cell phone, which I know the majority of us will probably be using our phones, you can make sure it says ISO.
ISO certified.
ISO certified if you're going to Amazon. Yeah. All the information will be in our website. We'll link yours as well. So, and then picking up your glasses, make sure those say ISO. Now, can you get these anywhere? Where did you get these? Can you get these at NASA?
These are from NASA.
Wow, these are serious. Okay, so these are professional. All right, so all the information that you need to know, again, on fox8.com. Thank you so much. Have fun.
Thank you.
Good
Thanks
luck.
Thanks for having me.
Maybe you can come back on with your photos.
Okay.
Okay.